All right. I want you to guess my word using this hill climbing approach that we've just been talking about. And unfortunately, well, we tried this with actual words and the space is a little bit big and frustrating. But what we can do instead is pretend that a 5-bit sequence is a word. So I'm thinking of a word, and by word, I mean 5 bits. And what we're going to do is I'm going to give you, for each time you guess a 5-bit sequence, I'm going to tell you the number of correct bits. So in each position, it's if you matched what I am thinking of in that position, then I give you an additional point for that.
Okay.
And you're going to now step through the hill climbing algorithm.
Okay. So three things. One, if you had done 8 bits, that would be a word. And
oh, nice.
Two, 4 bits is a nibble. Okay, here's the third thing. We need to define a neighbor function. So I'm going to define a neighbor function so that I can think about this is all 1-bit differences from where you are.
That's good. And an interesting question is, was it your job to come up with that or was it my job to come up with that? Now, is it part of the problem or is it part of the algorithm that's trying to solve the problem?
Huh. I'm going to say it's a part of the algorithm that's trying to solve the problem.
That's how I think of it, too.
All right, so we have to start somewhere, so let's just pretend for the sake of argument we started at all 5 zeros.
And I'm going to give you a score of 2 for that.
Okay, and so now I have to do all possible neighbors, and there are 5 of them. So there is 1 followed by 4 zeros, 0, 1 followed by 3 zeros, and, you know, the rest of the identity matrix.
All right, here's all your neighbors for the X where you were, mm-hmm. and here's the scores for all of those neighbors.
So there are 3 of them that are maximal, but for the sake of simplicity in drawing, I'm going to stick with the first one. So you can get rid of the bottom 4.
All right, so here's our new X.
Okay. And now I have to try all differences. So one of the neighbors would be all zeros, but I already know what that is, so I don't have to worry about that.
That's good. So the algorithm, the pseudocode that we wrote didn't do that optimization, but in general, that if, as long as the neighborhood function is symmetric, then you can save yourself a little bit of effort.
Right. So, or we could just keep track of everything we've ever seen, although that gets very space inefficient very quickly, since it's the identity matrix concatenated, prepended with the 1 matrix. Okay. So what are the numbers for that one? Wow. That's pretty cool. So it looks like we're getting there very quickly. So it's going to be, so the
in
best.
In fact, do we now have enough information that a smart human being could actually jump to the optimum?
Yeah, I think we do. I was actually thinking about that.
Let's see what happens.